Just got a new iPhone? Thinks there's gotta be a better alternative to the stuff you've been using? Whatever the case, you've researched and tested to find 13 essential apps. Let's get it. What's up guys, new update is here. This is the first part of the best iPhones app. And we're gonna begin with Firefox Focus. If targeted ads creep you out, or you just want to research something embarrassing without having to cycle through multiple menus to delete your histories, do your web browsing in this app. Firefox Focus blocks ad trackers, cleans your browser history, and can even be set to verify Face ID or Touch ID before you opening to existing pages. Number 2, 1.1.1. First of all, it's free. Even you don't know or care what DNS or domain name server or IP addresses are through this app on your iPhone. In short, it sends your internet traffic through Cloudflare, an esteemed cybersecurity company, rather than IPS like Verizon or AT&T. Meaning your connection to websites and services will be faster and better hidden from corporations looking to monetize your data. Number 3. City Mapper. Google Maps public transit function are reliable, but its algorithms can give some strange recommendation and can overlook options like scooters and bike shares. If you live in one of the cities that City Mapper covers, like New York, San Francisco, Toronto, Seoul, Tokyo, São Paulo, Moscow, and etc., chances are it gives you the fastest, most comprehensive list of choices for getting around on public transportation. Number 3. Fantastical 2. Apple's calendar is solid, so it's Google's. But if you, like many people, have your online identity split between your work email, a Gmail account, then an Apple ID on top of that, Fantastical is the answer. It unifies every event into one interface and handles change easily. And unlike Apple's calendar, Fantastical will even put your scheduled reminders next to your other events. But it is not free. Number 5. Geekbench 4. Smartphones, especially the iPhone, are designed to be beautiful and intuitive. They're meant to hide stuff like CPU processing speed rating from us. But if you are the kind of user who wants to know more about your iPhone or just test its battery health, Geekbench is the best overall diagnostic tool and a favorite of tech reviewers at Popular Mechanics. Number 6. RoboKiller. Anyone who gets bombarded with automated calls, install this app. Scam calls from the app's huge databases get blocked, so your phone never rings. If you're as petty as we are, you will enjoy the answer bot function, which automatically responds to these scams with programmed dialogue. Choose from options like Russian Hello, Number Discounted, or Morgan Freeman. If you get hit often enough, it's well worth the $13 a year membership. Number 7. Speed Test. Testing your connection speed is the first step in diagnosing networking issues. It's also a way to decide which Wi-Fi network to use and whether the connection is fast enough to download a few Netflix movies before your flight boards. Number 8. Tape a Call Pro. Call recording in US is a web of regulations, all of which means there are few options for doing this outside of using speaker phones and a dedicated recorder. Tape a Call Pro, however, get around this by merging call with its own servers, recording the call as if it were an additional party on the line. And yes, you still have to tell the person you're recording before you start. Number 9, Sweetcoin. Some people work to get fit, others need a bit more motivation. Sweetcoin is a fitness app that tracks your progress, giving you sweet coins in the process. You can then redeem these coins for real world rewards. And number 10, Gboard. Let's face it, you use Google search. In fact, statistically, you probably found this article through the Google search. So it makes sense that you'd want to use a keyboard that also harnesses the power of the world's most powerful search engine. Of course, Google's Gboard has other tips and tricks like fast GIF search and glit typing. It's a noticeable upgrade from what comes standard on an iPhone. So that was, guys, the first part of the best iPhones apps. Subscribe our channel, write a comment, and give us a like if you like.